So in today's video, I will start by a few minutes introduction. Then I will give you good habits to follow regarding nutrition. And finally, I will tell you bad habits that you need to change from now to get the body of your dreams. Okay, you cannot implement all good habits in one time or stop like all bad habits in one time. So try, for example, every week to convert one bad habit to a good habit or to add one new good habit to your everyday lifestyle. Okay, this will be realistic way for you to start to change, you know, your body, to change your life and get lean once for good. Hi, so in today's video I would like to talk about food technique to get lean. So food helps to build muscle but at rest, you know, so you're not actually making muscle when you are at the gym while you are training. You're gonna make muscle when you rest, so sleep also is very important. And do you know, big question is always, do I need cardio to get lean? Well, the short answer is no. But of course, what you need to do is eat well. This is mandatory, okay? So I think it's important to make it clear. Of course, cardio can help, especially if you do like AHT cardio, high intensity training, which is very good cardio technique to have the same result but in very short period of time. Well, if you eat well, you will become lean even without doing a lot of cardio. So this is very important to know. And actually, what is the best way to get lean is actually to do weight training. It's not cardio. So weight training plus good food, a bit of cardio and a good rest, no good resting time is very key. You can say, okay, what does it mean? In fact, it means that you need to build up some good habits. And it will take several weeks not to apply new habits to your everyday. So I think today's video is really about like, okay, try to change your habits, you know. This is what you need to focus on. Okay, so let's start about what is good, okay? What are good habits relating to food techniques, okay? And try to get lean as much as possible in a shorter period of time. So you need to understand that what you are doing is good or not. So one very good way it's trying to write down, okay, everything that you eat and everything that you drink, okay, because everything you're going to put in your body is going to change the way you are. So easy technique, you take a pen, a memo, you can use also a memo on your smartphone, and you try to write down what you eat, what you drink, the time, what exactly, and try to put as much as possible the quantity, okay, the volume of what you're eating. And it's important to really put everything in this list. Okay, even water or coffee has zero calorie, but at least you will know if you are taking too much caffeine or not enough. It can be a good help, you know. So this is a great method to really analyze what you're doing. You can also take picture when you do this, so it's more easy afterward to analyze what you take, for example, in a week. And you can analyze this like on a weekly basis, all this list. And also it will help you to understand if you're regular, you know, if you eat at a regular time, which is very important, even if you try like intermittent fasting, or if you eat like 5 times a day, or whatever. So there's a lot of techniques, but I think it's important to be consistent, okay? So you can eat at 7 a.m., 10 a.m., 1 p.m., 4 p.m., 7 p.m. if you have like 5 meals technique during the day, which has been proved that it's not actually that efficient, but so for some people it will be more easy way to keep insulin level as the same level. So you want to eat the same quantity. So if you want to do like 5 meals a day, you need to divide the same quantity that you usually having in 3 meals, but in 5 meals. And then this, you will understand what is the quantity by using calorie calculator and like this one. Okay. Another thing that is very important is to drink a lot of water. Okay. It means frequently during the day. You don't want to drink 1 liter in one time. And you want to drink at least 2 liters of water. Okay. It's recommended by many analyses. Another very easy technique, it's divide the plate by 3 categories. So you want to have vegetable, you want to have good source of carb, and you want to have also great source of protein. And for the protein, you want to, you know, to try as much as possible to get, like, for example, chicken and fish, because they have low fat. And for example, for carbs, you want to use a great source of also carbs. So it can be like potato, baked potato. You don't have to cook it with fat. It can be beans. With great vegetables also, like avocado, salad, everything that can be as green as possible. Okay, another super cool technique is to burn, as you can burn fat a lot in the morning when you're on an empty stomach. Studies show that you can burn 2.5 times actually more fat if you do this in the morning on an empty stomach compared to in an evening. So the same cardio training. So you want to eat also your breakfast after you do your training. It can be cardio training or it can be your weight training in the morning, but you want to eat after this, okay? Not before. This is very important. For cardio, as I say, I recommend like HIIT cardio to save time instead of traditional cardio. And you can apply this, but only if you have a good health, no else. You don't want to do this if you have a heart issue. So it cannot apply to everybody. In other video, I will explain more about HIIT training and the benefit you can get from it. But basically, it's to optimize your cardio training time, you know. Okay, eat quality food. This is very important. You need to count your calories, you need to know what you're getting, but you need to focus to eat very good food, okay? This is important because the same amount of calorie of bad food is not equal to good food, okay? Your body will not react the same. Good food can be nicely digested, you know, and will help you to get lean. Brown rice is better than white rice, you know. White rice is better than bread, for example, you know. So you need to consider, you need to know this. Another great habit is to eat one fruit a day. So it's easy to get it with your breakfast. You can take oatmeal, you know, which is a very great source of carb, with one fruit. It can be one banana, one kiwi, whatever. Use good source of carb, you know. Avoid white bread, avoid cheap pasta, use brown rice, like I said, beans, potatoes, pumpkins, oatmeal. You don't want to use like processed food, which is the worst stuff you can get. So all calorie made, all this kind of handmade energy drink or whatever, okay? This is all garbage. One other stuff that is the best is probably is use high protein diet, you know? And also understand the importance of fibers. You want to get great vegetables like carrot, avocado, broccoli, spinach, a lot of green, because they have a lot of fibers. So for good source of protein, you want to eat seafood as much as possible. So you want to use chicken instead of red meat. Red meat is very good, great source of power. So you can use it several times a week, but you can limit when you do a very high or very heavy training, you know, because it will give you more energy. I think many people feel like a lot of energy using red meat. So you can limit, you know, red meat like twice a week when you're doing like big muscle, like legs or chest and sometimes back, you know. Another good trick, you can do a crazy meal once a week. So which means you can eat everything you want, but try to limit to one meal a day. And usually, you know, many people will do on Saturday lunch or Sunday lunch because you're on the weekend, so you can go to a place you like and eat a lot of garbage. And it's fine to do it once a week, you know. And it will help you a lot to release like stress, you know, and temptation during like your period, not diet period, but while you're trying to change your habit, okay? Another good technique is limit amount of carb at dinner. Of course, your body needs a bit of carb in the evening, but it's mainly for the brain to recover, okay? So you can limit the quantity of carb to, for example, half of what you used to eat, no? And it will change a lot. It will help you to get lean very quickly. Okay, second part. What are the bad stuff to eat, bad stuff to do, okay? So you want to avoid as much as possible alcohol. Okay, it's difficult for many of us, but at least try to limit like to once a week, once a month, your consumption of alcohol. because there is a lot of calories in alcohol, even we can consider that vodka is one of the best, but still, you know, I mean, you're usually drinking vodka with orange juice or with something, so this will bring also a lot of calories additionally to the alcohol calories, which is already a lot. So let's not try to say, okay, beer is the worst and vodka is the best. I think you just want to limit your consumption of alcohol, okay? Another thing that is quite bad actually is taking a lot of salt. So salt is kind of your enemy, so you really want to limit the consumption of salt also, okay? And if you avoid like processed food, like potato chips and all that crap, you should be already in a good direction. Why avoiding salt? Because your body will retain a lot of liquid, okay, for everything that you're drinking, even water. So it's not going to help you to get lean, okay? Black pepper will actually, but so, okay, you know it already, but you need to avoid sugar, and especially the bad one, not the one coming from the fruits, but coming from ice cream, cookies, or soda that you can imagine, even juice that are sold in your supermarket. All these juice that are handmade, they are full of sugar, full of crap, even if they say it's 100%. So if you want to drink good juice, please make it yourself. Put it in a mixer and okay, get it from real fruits. Stop buying and stop drinking juice from supermarket. This is crap. Okay, I said it already a lot of times. Avoid processing food or avoid everything that is made by human, okay, like all those fancy cereals and all that shit. Stop. I will put some example here. Okay, this is just not good for you, okay? Okay, avoid very fatty food, okay? Very quick example, okay, bacon, sausages at your breakfast, for example. Try to switch to eggs, try to switch to good stuff, you know, salmon. You can do some fish in the morning also, okay, even if you're not living in Japan like me. But you can change your habits. Okay, another bad stuff is to sleep just after you get your dinner or your lunch or whatever, okay? You don't want to go to bed just after eating. This is quite bad. Or if you're taking a nap, you just want to limit your nap to about 1 hour. Many studies show that sleeping 30 minutes or 1 hour in the afternoon is actually quite good. But over that period of time, you will just store all the fat, okay? Another stuff, avoid all dairy products, all milk-based products. You can replace milk by almond milk, and there is a lot of sugar-free almond milk on the market that are quite good. And it can help you to get your breakfast or your oatmeal with this, but stop taking yogurt and all that milk-based product. This is just not a good way to get lean, okay? And it's full of fat, so yeah. So cheese, yogurt, we don't need these products, okay? So if you like the video, please put a like and subscribe to my channel to support. Many thanks, and don't hesitate to put also comment below. Okay, have a good day, bye.